The annual Defense and Security Equipment International Conference, better known as DSEI, and held this year in London, was a showcase of some of the latest and most advanced tech, large and small, being offered to militaries around the globe. We were on the floor at the show to see some of the systems being rolled out and found some interesting items covering the full spectrum of military and defense needs. First up, a new submersible for special operations troops that aims to fill a gap between the Zodiac and a submarine. We spoke to a representative from James Fisher Defense about the Shadow Seal.
So what we have here is our latest Shadow Seal, we call it. So it's for really insertion over in a denied environment. These are tactical diving vehicles, so we are working on helping cross the water gap in denied environments. So the beauty of these is they've got both overwater capability, and then they transition to both semi-submerged or fully submerged to be able to operate in denied environments covertly and get operators to the shore. This can operate 80 nautical miles over the surface and 40 nautical miles underwater at about 4 to 5 knots. The beauty with this is you can see it's got a mast there with a camera. It's also got navigation support from that, so you can operate in the surf zone, so in like a 10 to 15 feet of water, 2 to 3 meters of water, which allows you to comfortably travel covertly underwater over long distances using breathing air from the boat. So you can keep fairly comfortable onto target. You can pop up and check with the mast in terms of positional accuracy, and also operating in that surf zone of water. It's kind of acoustically noisy, which means you can more or less hide and be fairly undetected.
Up next, a cardboard drone. Defense News' Megan Eckstein brings us a report.
Behind me is SIPAC's Precision Payload Delivery System, otherwise known as their cardboard drone. They have developed this back in 2018, originally meant to deliver small supplies to the field, including blood bags, small bits of ammunition, radios, that type of thing, to soldiers out in the field who may not be accessible for resupply by other means. But Australia gifted about 600 of these cardboard drones to Ukraine, and they've been heavily used in operations in Ukraine, with soldiers even punching holes in the bottom and stringing GoPros through them to use them as sort of ad hoc ISR systems. So behind me, we have the cardboard drone unfolded for operations. It has minimal avionics and a motor underneath. It has a pouch that opens up for the soldiers to retrieve the payload that's inside. This is what it looks like before it's unfolded. It's made of cardboard, it folds up like cardboard, and it's very easily transportable as such. So soldiers in the field would receive this. They could set it up as needed. They could throw whatever resupply system, whatever GoPro, whatever payload they want onto it and send it right on its way. It gets launched by throwing it in the air or by using a catapult. And you can either pre-program it to come back to you and retrieve it, or because it's cardboard, it's disposable. So if it goes on a one-way mission, you just send it out. It's cardboard, it's biodegradable. And so you can just count it as a loss and move on.
Thanks, Megan. Next up, a tank without good vision is just a big, heavy target on the battlefield. So defense developers are always looking to improve what tankers can see. At DSEI, G&H, the makers of the British main battle tank's next generation imaging system, were on hand to show off the latest version of the eyes of the Challenger. We spoke with the company about its capabilities.
This is the embedded image periscope. It combines digital technology and sensor-based situational awareness with a reversionary capability. Its main selling point is that in the event that power goes down in a vehicle, the crew can switch to just a normal direct view piece of glass. So its one aim in life is to make sure that the crew are protected and they can get out of a situation when they need to. On a day-to-day basis, it runs from a thermal camera, a day camera, with an overlay on top. And it provides situational awareness and can be connected to reversing cameras and any other cameras on the vehicle. The reversionary aspect of it has been mandated by the UK MOD, and it is a flagship product. It will, for Challenger 3, include a biocular viewer, which you can also see, and that provides eye relief and a more wider view for the driver. So the EIP for Challenger is a driver's vision system aid. The product doesn't have to be in the driver's position. We have another opportunity currently in Central Europe where the system actually has two of the periscopes, one in the commander's position and one in the driver's position. But in Challenger, it's a driver's aid. This is actually called a Spectre camera unit. It can also be standalone with some adjustments for unmanned vehicles, but this particular camera pack has a long wave infrared and a day camera. It can be configured to also have short wave infrared. It can have all three, and it feeds into obviously the unit.
And now, who could refuse this little guy? On display at DSEI was the Taha 1200, a delivery and evacuation vehicle designed to cover some very challenging terrain. Technically called the Taha Amphibious All-Terrain Combat Vehicle, this mighty mouse is designed to carry supplies to troops in the field or evacuate them from difficult areas when the need arises. It can transit a range of wet and watery terrain, including Arctic areas where its maker said it has the ability to climb out of a hole in the ice if it ever breaks through. Made by Ukrainian manufacturers, the Taha has 71-inch tires and a maximum cruising speed of 25 miles per hour. For more of our coverage from DSEI, head to defensenews.com/digitalshowdailies/DSEI.